Is my screen visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the topic is MVSS tree. So I told in the beginning of the lecture that we are going to study many types of tree data structure. A majority of the tree data structure that deals with data management with respect to internal memory, that is a ROM and RAM kind of memory. But there are certain data structure like B tree, B plus tree, MVSS tree, splay tree, red black tree. There are so many trees are available, and those trees dealt with the data management with respect to external memory, right? So before understanding the B tree, say you can directly go and understand the B tree, but anyhow, before understanding the B tree, you need to have a little idea about the MVSS tree, right? So when you are going to study AVL tree, you should have little knowledge about binary search tree, right? When you are going to study binary search tree, you should have little knowledge about binary tree, right? When you are going to study binary tree, you should have little knowledge about what is tree, what is node, what is left child, what is right child, what is degree, and like that other stuff. So after that only you can enter into binary tree. After studying binary tree, you should analyze the limitations of binary tree. Then in order to overcome the limitations of binary tree, you go into binary search tree. Then after a while, you find the limitations of binary search tree, like it is inclined towards a particular direction. That means the skewed nature, left skewed binary search tree, right skewed binary tree. Again, it seems to be a linear search. So what you can do is you have to make a height as a factor, and you should maintain the height as a balanced one. So you come to AVL tree, right? Yeah, so that turned all for primary memory, that is internal memory, and this MVSS tree, B tree, B plus tree are meant for external memory. So MVSS tree is equivalent to binary search tree. So what is the property of the binary search tree? The same property holds good for MVSS tree, whereas B tree is equivalent to AVL search tree. That is the properties of MVSS tree plus the height factor. So if you include the height factor in the tree, then it is going to be B tree. And binary search tree, the B plus tree is a simple addition in the concept when compared with the B tree. So that thing we will see one by one. So what is MVSS search tree? It is a kind of tree that is used in external memory, and it is used for what is that? Retrieval, data storage, data manipulation, those kind of stuff. So in general, it is called as generalized version. So you see, whatever the tree concept that you studied in binary search tree, the same concept is applied here, but with a little modification in order for external memory. So what is the objective of this memory is you have to when you are retrieving your data, so you need to access the you have to minimize the access. That is, if when your root node is there, and if you want to search the node, if that node is at some 10th or 12th level depth, so what you have to do is this kind of tree will make the node that is present at the 10th or 12th level, maybe 100th level, that is the maybe the situation when you imagine a very big tree. So into a level very little and very closer and very smaller, maybe to the second level or third level like that. So in that case, the MVSS tree contains a node, or the MVSS tree is constructed by using a node. That node contains M minus one key elements and the M address field. So key elements here refers to data. Say for example, if you are going to store your data like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what you will do, one is situated at the root node, two is situated at the left child, three is situated at the right child, like that. So, but here in the case of this MVSS tree, you may treat that M, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the values as a root node, all the root node, so single node. That means M minus one key elements and M address field. So accordingly, the data is, the tree is constructed. Say for example, look at the tree, a single node in the MVSS. See, this is a single node. So what is the elements? 18, 44, 70. So here you need not designate a single value as the root node. All these four values are treated as the root node. So this is the MVSS tree. Why it is this is a 5SS tree? Why it is 5SS tree? Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are five possible ways are there. Five possible ways are there. So it is a MVSS tree. That is 5SS tree. For 18, this is the left child and this is the right child. The right child of 18 should become the left child of 44. This is the right child of 44. Again, the right child of 44 will become the left child of 44, and it has a separate right child. This right child will become the left child of 198, and it should have a separate right child. So when you are going to construct a tree, so you have to construct a tree in such a way that you should have M address field and M minus 1 key field. Say for example, if it is as a 3 and you are going to store the item 18, 21, 30, like that. So this is the address field, one address field, second address field, third address field. And this is left right of 18. This right of 18 will become the left of 21, and right of this one become the left of right of 21, and this 30 left is this one and right is this one. So accordingly you should consider it. And you look at it, the value is seen in the increasing order. Say for example, 18 is the location, 44 next to it because it is the next bigger number, 76 is the next bigger number, 128 is the next biggest number. So the values are arranged in the increasing order like this. So that is for the search property, binary search property. So this is the case here also, 18, 21, 30, like that. So if you want to construct a complete tree like this, see like this, a complete tree. So what is 18? 18 is a root node, and it has a left child and right child. Right child is made null. Right child is made null by the left child. So when you go for left child, the two values here should be less than 18, 712. So it is, what is the kind of node? It is a three-way node. It is a three. So totally the tree is a five-way search tree because of the five address fields in the root node. But intermediate node can have any number of key elements as well as address fields. So this is a two-way, this is a three-way because it has a three. One, two, three. So that is a three-way search tree, and it has a two elements, 712. And here you have 198, this is 44. Both left side and right side is null. 76, left side is null, right side is having pointer. So if you look at it, so this pointer address field is for right side of 76 as well as left side. So if you look, consider the value of this node, this 80, 92, 141 are greater than 76 as well as it is less than 198. So greater than 976 and less than 198, 80, 92, 141. So if you take the 80, it has a two address field. This is left address field is connected to a node 77, right address field is null, and this 92 right address field is null, 141 left address field is a right address field. So all the elements should be greater than 141. See, if you look at it, 148, 151, 172, 186, all are greater than 180. So then if you can take the case of this node, this 262 is at the right, so x is the left and the right have empty. Also, the right is attached with the set of elements. This element should be definitely greater than the 262. So this is the way the binary search tree property is satisfied. So that's what I'm saying. The binary search tree property is satisfied, should be satisfied, or it is otherwise said that the generalized version of a MBA search tree. Sorry, binary search tree. So when you are going to search, what is the operation with this MBA search tree? Insertion operation, searching operation, and other things. Other things, right? So searching operation, MBA search tree is constructed similar to binary search tree. Searching is carried out by comparing the values. To search 77, begin from root 77 greater than 76. So go right of 76. Then in the second level, 77 less than 80. So go left of, so like that. So whenever you have an element, you compare the element, and according to the compared value, either you go right or go left. So that is the binary search tree property. The same binary search tree property is applicable in MBA search tree. When you compare to insertion, also the same thing. Say when you going to insert 6, insert 46. Let us take these two examples, how to insert the 6 and how to insert the value 46. So when you are going to insert 6, so first you should identify in which location you have to insert 6. So you compare the value of 6 with the root node. So in root node you have 18. So you 18. So that is goes to left. So when you go to left, you have 712. So you can insert 7 here. Since it is a M way search tree, for any child node, you can have maximum M way. M way means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here M equal to 5. So when you are going to insert any data node in a particular node that is already available, you should check whether the slot is available or not. How do you check the slot? because previously this contains only this value, that is only three address field is there. So two more address field can be possible. That means one data item can be inserted. Two data items can be inserted. So accordingly, you need to find the position as well as you need to find the free slot, and that way you have to insert the data element, right? So 146. What is 146? What is 146? Where I have to insert 146? See, I am checking in the value of 146. See, it is greater than 76 and less than 198. So I have to go to this link, and I am checking here 80, 92, 141. So it is greater than 141. So I am going to choose this link, and I am going to insert 148, 151, 170. So 146 should be here. Should be here. But it is not possible for me to insert. Why it is not possible? Because already this node is a full node. Already this node is a full node. Why it is set as full node? Because all the address fields are m equal to 5. So 5 address fields are made. All the m minus 1 key fields. All the m minus 1 key fields. All the m minus 1 key fields. That is 4 key fields. All the 4 key fields are available with the data. So what do you have to do? You have to take a pointer from this location. That is, you make the under your term left. It means why it is inserted in the left side, because 146 is a value lesser than 148. So whenever you want to insert a node, you have to check whether that m minus 1 key element field is full or not. If it is not full, you insert at the location. If it is full, then you have to identify a suitable location, and accordingly you have to fill the value. So this is what you need to do when you are going to do the insertion operation. Likewise the deletion also in MVSS tree. So what you have to do is you have to check, say for element, this is a element, say this is a generic diagram, this is the element you want to delete, and this element has a left subtree as well as a right subtree, right? So when you are going to delete a node, you have to check whether this AL is AR is equal. So if that two address field is null, this two address field is null, then it is very easier for you to delete E. In case AL is null and AL is not null and AR is null, then what you have to do is, then the largest of the key element E dash in the child node. So there will be some child node below, right? So in that below node, what you have to do, you have to take a largest element and you have to replace it in the place E. In case if AL equal to null and AR equal to null, what you have to do then, that is in the right side, you have to take the smallest element of the E dash. There might be some sub child from that child, you have to take the smallest element and you have to replace it with the E. You suppose if both the AL and AR both are null, what you have to do, so that is obvious, then you have to take either in the smaller side, like you go in the left side, you can go take the largest value. If you go in the right side, then you have to take the smallest value and replace the. So now that is an example in order to make you to understand the problem. See, that is, you have to delete 151, 92, 12, 262 here. So this is the tree that is we have seen in the insertion case. The same tree is here. So in this tree, what the element you have to delete is, first of all, you have to delete 151. Where 151 is there, 151 is here. So what is the case according to the MVSS tree deletion? It's a left sub pointer AL as well as a right pointer AR. Both are null, right? So since both are null, it is easier for you to delete 151. So next, what is the element you have to delete? You have to delete the 92. So 92 also, that AL as well as AR are null, so it is easier for you to delete 92. So this two items that is deleted based on the case one. Now coming to, after deleting, the tree is like this. See, 151 that is gone and 92 that is gone from here, right? Now, so, hey, case 2, delete the element 12. So where the 12 is there, so you see here the 12 is there. Here, what is the second case? AL, that is a left pointer, is not null, whereas the right pointer is null. So in that case, what you have to do, if the left pointer is null, you have to take the largest element among the two element and place it in the place of 12. So after that operation, see, you have to take the largest element. So 10 is originally here and it is taken and it is placed in the place of 12 and the 12 is removed. 12 is removed, right? So what is the case 3? Delete 262. So where is the 262? 262 is here. So 262 left pointer is null and right pointer is null. So in case if that situation arises, what you have to do is, you have to take a smallest element among the child element. So what is the smallest element among the child element? 272. So you have to take the 272 and replace it in the place of 262. So that is the idea here. 272 and 262. 286, and you have to place it here, and you have to place it here. So that is the third case. So what is the fourth case? In case both are not null, so that is obvious, right? What is that case? This one, maybe you can take this one, case four. This is also not null. This is also not null. So if that is the situation, what you can do? Either you can choose a element here, bigger element, right side, smaller, only one element is there, or in here, the left side, small 141, you can bring it here. So like that, you can do that kind of stuff. And the fourth case is coming in case of your stake in your mind. Then this is the important topic in your syllabus. In order to understand this tree, only MVSS tree I have taught you. But most of the things are common with respect to binary, that is MVSS tree and balanced MVSS tree. What is B tree? It is balanced MVSS tree. So both are common. The only thing you need to know the height factor. In order to estimate the height factor, what you have to do is you need to check whether these three properties are satisfied or not. What are the properties? The root has at least two child nodes. So when your root is there, so it should have at least two child nodes. It should have. That means if the root is having one element, 78 is the root element, it should have at least two child nodes. And at most m child nodes, if it is m equal to 5, then you have m child nodes. That means m address field, minimum 2 address field, maximum m address field. That's what the idea here, minimum 2, maximum m. The internal nodes have at least m by 2 child nodes. So if the order is m equal to 5, then m by 2 means 3. So minimum it should have 3 child pointers, or maximum it should have 5 child pointers. That means the left and right child pointer. And you should always ensure that the leaf node should be at the same level. All leaf nodes should be at the same level. Accordingly, you should do the other process. Everything, the insertion and deletion are similar to the MVSS tree. But because of this balanced condition, you should check that stuff also. What is that step? Whether these condition like the root node should have 2 to m, minimum 2 address field and maximum m address field. The internal node should have minimum 3 address field, maximum 5 address, that is m address field. And you should always ensure that all the leaf nodes should be on the same level. So let me take an example. This is a B tree of order 5. So because of the slide size, the node is I have made a node like this by making a connection like this, right? So it has a 48 as the root node, and see, if you look at it, so it is the order of 5, so minimum 2 address field is there, right? And the maximum, how many address field is there? Maximum 4 address field. Intermediate node should have m by 2, minimum m by 2. It should not go below that. Minimum m by 2, and the maximum it have m by 2 means 3 for this case, and you can have 4 or you can have 5. So this is here 3 and here you have 4, right? So likewise, you have to draw the tree, and you have to ensure that all level leaf nodes should be at the same level. You should not confuse with that this one single leaf node comes to your next level. See, these are in the same level. In order for the data item to be in the same level, due to the space limitation, the slide I have little drawn in the downward side, but otherwise it should be in the same level. So in order to say that the height is a balanced one and the leaf nodes are at the same level. So operations in a B tree, again, searching operation is similar to a MVSS tree, and you have to check whether the lesser value, lesser left side, greater value for right side. Insertion. So insertion is a little bit trickier. What are the procedures that you have to follow for MVSS tree? That same procedure is being followed here also, in B tree also, but with a certain restriction. See, when you are going to insert a node, you have to check for the full node. What is a full node? If m equal to 5, then you should have m address field. If m address fields are present, then even the present means it may be a null pointer or it may be a valid pointer. So that is not a bother. So it should be present. So here all the m address fields are present. So then it is a full node. But here this is not a full node. Here this is not a full node, right? So you should know what is a full node and what is a not full node in order to conduct the insertion. Because if it is a full node, you cannot insert. And if it is not a full node, you can insert. So that thing you should remember. Here also you have an example. To insert any node, let me read that point. To insert any node into the B tree, first check the suitable position. How to check the suitable position? You should check the value property. If the value is lesser, you would go to the left side. The value is greater, you go to the right side. So according to the value property, you should check the suitable position. According to the suitable position, after the suitable position is identified, and then you have to check whether the node is full or not. If it is not full, you can insert. If it is full, what you can do is you need to do some alternate arrangements. See, the node is full. So if the node is full, you cannot say that, no, I cannot insert. You cannot simply say that, or you cannot reject the task. You should, however, accept the task and should see to the possibility where I can insert the node. So how to insert the node? So you know, you have to make that node as a not full node. Because it is a full node, you have to make the node is a not full node. In order to make the node as a full node, what you have to do is you have to split the node into two at the median. So if it has five, address field maximum, then you have to divide the two. So one is with the three address field, another one is with the two address field, right? By pushing the element, the median element should be pushed up one level upward. So in case if we have a no five address element key like this, say for example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so here you have element 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. It is the case you have to split it in the median. So median is 3, right? So 3 should now go to as a root node, and it have two address field. One address field contains the element 1, 2, and it is null values, null pointer values, and another right pointer will have the value as 4, 5, and it is address field is located like this, right? So that is the idea here. So we're pushing the element up by one. So what do you do? You need to push the element only. So if you push the element, and the above level also, if you have any data, so then it is again an insertion, right? Here the situation is the insertion is happened in the root node. So you are forming a new root node. Suppose if it is at the intermediate level, and at that intermediate level you are splitting the node into two half, and you are making the node that is median node to be become a one node up level. So what you got to do is you have to check the parent node, whether it is full or not. You have to check the parent node. So even that parent node is full, again it seems to be another instance. You have to see the process. So if you are doing this process again and again, what you will do is you will form a, you will make a some kind of rearrangement. You will make a some kind of rearrangement of the keys, and finally you will form a new root. So let us explain this insertion operation with the help of an example. So what are the, this is a given tree, you are going to insert the element 4 and 5. So first let me see how to insert the 4 and 5. Since the 4 and 5 are less than 86, you have to go to the left pointer. So in the left side, you have only two elements, 2 and 5. Maximum, there is a 5 order row, so maximum two elements can be accommodated here. So 2, 4, 5. So those two elements have been inserted without any rearrangement or without any splitting operation. So you need to do two operations. One is splitting. So if you keep on doing the splitting, you may find you may end up with some rearrangement of nodes if I form a new root node. So those stuff is not there. Insert 58. So 58 is inserted. So where the 58 is inserted? Here. 58 is inserted. So 58 should be inserted here. 58 should be inserted here. But it is already filled. So what you have to do? You have to divide the node into two half. So while dividing the node into two half, the 55 goes one side upward, right? So the 55 goes one side upward. So where upward? So this is the median element. So 55 goes in the, but the root node is having one slot free. Since one slot is free, 55 goes without any struggle, and 58 is. Now what is got to do? What you have to, you are going to insert 6. While you are going to insert 6, where is the suitable position for inserting 6? So 6 can be inserted here. So but already you have a 6, you have to insert it here. Already this is full. So what you have to do? You have to divide it into 2. And when you are dividing into 2, you have to push the 5 upward. While you're pushing the 5 upward, again this node is full. Right? So you have to split it into 2. So then the 55 will go upward, and this is split into 2. So 5 is attached there, and 58 and 96, 796. So like that. The process is like that. So what is done here? So in order to insert 6, the best position for 6 is here. But the node is full node. So what you have to do, according to the property, you have to split it. While you are splitting it, You can make a 2-4 as one and a 6-7 as another, that the median element 5 should go upward. While making the 5 to go upward, already this node is also filled with the 8-5. So this is attached here. After attached here, filled, splitting the element into 2. So 5-8 is available as one node. 96 and 116 is another node. So this 55 will be move one layer upward. That is some kind of rearrangement, to say, with the introduction of one more layer. And even though one more layer is introduced, the leaf node should be all in the same level. So this is what the insertion is all about. Come to deletion in a B tree. So deletion in a B tree also chooses three cases. The case one is that is whether the node that is going to be deleted, it should be a leaf node or intermediate node. If it is a leaf node or intermediate node, you no need to worry about it. Just you have to check whether it contains more than the minimum number of elements. So leaf node and intermediate node, what is the minimum number of elements? M by 2, right? M by 2. So you should ensure that M by 2 elements, M by 2 address field. M by 2 address field means if it is 5, 3 address fields, so minimum 2 elements should be there. So if it contains more than the minimum number of elements, no need. You can delete it. In case it contains just the minimum element, see? In case it contains just a element, so deleting it will disturb the property of the B tree. So in order to maintain the property of the B tree, what you can do is you can borrow a node either from the left side or from the right side or from the successor or from the predecessor. So while you are borrowing the node, again it is a kind of deletion, right? If that situation is also comes, then again you have to do the borrowing process. Like the borrowing process goes on at a level by level, will resulting in the task of height reduction. So there splitting is there, here borrowing is there. In insertion, splitting, here in deletion, borrowing. In insertion, you make a rearrangement forming a new root node by increasing the level, but the leaf node are at the same level. But during the deletion, there will be a reduction in the height, as well as all the leaf nodes should be in the same level. That is what deletion. Let me explain it in the next example. So this is a tree. Here, what you have to delete? You have to delete 95, 226, 221, 70, right? First of all, you should delete 95. So where is 95? 95 is there. Since it is the minimum, it is easily deleted. It is easily deleted. So leaf node contains more than the minimum number, is easily deleted. Next, result entry after set deleted. Delete 226. So 226, where it is available, 226. See, it is having just the minimum element. So you will not delete it. If you delete it, then the B tree property is not satisfied. So what you do? You have to borrow either from the left side, right side, successor, predecessor. What is left side? So 226 left side is this one. 226 right side is this one. 226 predecessor is this one. So whatever it may be, you have to borrow something, right? So what is the element that is borrowed here? So here the borrowed is number 300. 300 is borrowed. 300 is borrowed. That 226 is deleted because here it is having the minimum number of elements. This node is also minimum. So this is the one which is having more than the minimum number. So that is borrowed, and that element is borrowed. So here the borrowing operation is deleting. So in order to delete the element 226 that is in this location, what this is deleted, but instead of that, in place of this, what is deleted again? 300 in this level is deleted and is taken from this location. This is result entry after deleting 226. I hope you understand. So then you have to delete 221. 221 is here. So this is just the minimum number of elements. And you have to borrow the elements from this side. The successor side you have to borrow because these are all siblings which doesn't have any proper connections. But what you can do is you can bring this 440 here and 300 here, like that. Is some zigzag thing you can do, right? So 440 goes up there, then 300. So there are two deletion is carried out by borrowing the elements from here and there. So now all the properties have been satisfied, right? Now what is the element delete 70? Where 70 is there? 70 is here. So in order to do the 70, you have to maintain the property where you have to buy the bought element in downside. We don't have any element that is a successor also doesn't have, and the left and right child also doesn't have. So what do you can do? Do the predecessor. If you do the predecessor again, what do you do? This is just contain the minimum element, so it is not possible. So here you can either go for left side and right side. So that is also not possible. So you have to borrow the element from here only. You have to borrow the element from here only in order to delete. So what you can do, you can just push this element. So what is So here you borrow the 65. If you borrow the 65, so this is going to not following the property. So what are you going to do? You can bring 86 there. And then 110 is already available. Then 120, then 440, and for the element put together, that is 86, 110, and 120, and 440. Four elements are put together and is formed as a single node. So what is that? One layer is, or one level is reduced, completely reduced. So resulting in the height reduction. So that is the idea here. See? Resulting in the height reduction. So only two layer level of node. Only two layer level. So this is what the deletion is all about. So there are some exercise problems that deals with MVS HT and B-tree. The answer for the MVS HT problems are being solved by your peer students during the regular class. So you can refer the Google Classroom for the answer solution for these kind of problems. So that is the very short of yes.
No sir. Okay sir.
Okay, so this is a very small topic. I think instead of going for the next class, I think we will finish it during this class, because up to that the topic is over. So very easy here. B plus tree, that is, it is just an extension of the B tree. So what is the extension of the B tree is all elements hold good. B tree, see, B plus tree, so it is the extension of B tree. So what is the thing is whatever the idea with respect to MVS HT and B tree, all hold goods for this B plus tree. But what is the thing is, see, in the last layer there is a connection. There is a connection. So this is the small change in the B plus tree. So that is there with the respect to see in B tree, keys and records both can be stored in the internal as well as in the leaf nodes. Whereas in B plus tree, records can only be stored on the leaf nodes, while the internals can store only the key values. So what is the record here is just a references. So B plus tree also used, which cannot be stored in the main memory due to the fact that the size of the main memory is always limited. So it is a more advanced form of the B tree, because the leaf nodes are B tree. See, the leaf nodes of B plus tree are linked together to form a single linked list. See, like a single linked list, the leaf nodes are getting joined. That is the only idea. Other all operations like insertion operation. So when you want to insert the one element 195 here, since it is the order of 5, so where you have to insert the 195, so it is going the right side the elements are full. So what you see here, the address field is like this. Sir, in B tree you have a two layer node like this. You draw, so in the below you have address field, the above you have a data field. But here, see, this is another way of representing the node. So this is the left child and the right child of the node 60. So this is one layer representation of the node. This is the two layer representation of the node. The first layer contains data, the second layer contains address, but this is the one layer representation. Both are same. Either you can draw the diagram like this, or you can draw the like. Some other is using these kind of diagrams in order to differentiate from the data field as well as from the address field. But here the data field and address fields are in the same thing. Right. So what is this empty space? This empty space would be the right pointer of 60 as well as the left pointer of 78. So what is this space? This is space is right pointer of 78 and the left pointer. So like this you can do. You can draw the B plus tree. So when you are going to insert 195, so the 195 should be inserted here. Inserted here. So if you inserted here, what you can do? The data is the node is very large and it is not following the properties. So what you have to do? Split it into median. So median means that 190 should go upward. So 190, if you go upwards, again it is a filled node. So what is you have to do? You have to split it in the median, and that 108 should go upward. So that is the idea. 108 is going upward. 60, 78 is there. 120, 198 there. So comfortably you have filled the 195 here. So one, the thing is, this operation is similar to the operation of B tree. The thing is, this arrowhead. So every leaf node should be invited. Likewise, the deletion here, if you want to delete the number 200, see, you should satisfy the property M by 2 child node, right? That property M by 2. So since this is the order of, I think the order is, yeah, this is having maximum, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the order of 5. So you should maintain the minimum. So when you are going to delete 20, you should borrow the values. When you are going to borrow the values, you can borrow the values 190. You should borrow the values 190. So if you borrow the value 190, so what you can do is you can do for merging instead of doing that. So what is it? The link is there. You can merge these two elements. You can merge these two elements. See, 190, you brought it back and it is merged. So see, it can be left like this. Now, if I want to delete another element, say for example, if the 120 is the element which is left one, that is not possible. So what you can do is you can all combine these three elements. So that is the situation. So whenever you want to do a deleting an element, you should ensure that the minimum number of address fields as well as the minimum number of minimum or address fields both in the intermediate level as well as in the leaf level should be satisfied. If not satisfied, you should either borrow it. While you are going to borrow it, you make some kind of rearrange. See, here also the reduction in the height compared similar to the beep tree. So when you are borrowing, deleting a node, always it reduces to shrink of the node level. That means that might be a reduction in the data height. So this is the difference. So everything is same. Everything is same. What is the thing is the leaf nodes are linked. Here leaf nodes cannot be linked together. Here leaf nodes are linked together. Here, the deletion of the inter nodes are no complicated and time consuming. See, a deletion will never be a complex process since the element is always deleted from the leaf nodes. See, deletion is very easier in comparison. Searching for the same data, see here, searching is very slower, but here, the redundancy can be searching is comparatively faster because of the leaf nodes. Again, that is the interlink connection. So, the thing is faster when compared with the B tree as well as B plus tree. So, in general, the advantages of a tree structure is the file organization. File organization, the tree, the data structure is useful, that is especially B plus tree. Wherever you have faster data retrieval, or wherever you need faster queries, or wherever you need keys for indexing, that is when you want to access the data environment with minimum number of disk access. So what you can do is you can go for always the B plus tree, that is the advantages. This is a general application of a tree. It can be used for data compression. It can be used as several file systems of applications, evaluating arithmetic expression like infix, postfix, and prefix expression that you have seen, game playing, searching, etc. So tree is a wonderful data structure, and it finds a lot of applications and lot of users. So I invite you to refer these websites for additional material in addition to the thing that we have discussed. And if possible, you can refer these YouTube channels for better understanding of the certain problems, right? Okay. I think I stop the class. I hope you understand the idea. So you rest of the material, you follow it in the Google Classroom. And I hope it will be helpful to you. And you will be enjoying a lot while reading the subject. So whatever may be the doubt you are having, you can clarify me either through my email or to my WhatsApp, right? So
okay, sir.
I am stopping the record here.